but it's Lincoln Southeast, the dominant program over the last two decades. This will be their 12th appearance on Championship Saturday, but they have lost two in a row. Now, our producers couldn't narrow down the map small enough to show you where the high schools are, but for those of you not familiar with Lincoln, there it is. Lincoln East, 18-4. They have lost every game against Lincoln Southeast dating back to 1988, which ironically is kind of the time where Southeast started to take command as the power in Class A, and Southeast started to back off.
Unbelievable. And the biggest thing in this game, I just talked to the Lincoln East coach, Todd McMesser, and he said, just believing that we can win this game, that we can compete with Lincoln Southeast. It should be a great final in Class A.
So we'll be back for the starters, the players, and the Class A championship next.
The harmonies. It's the memories.
I started a joke.
The Bee Gees, one night only.
Monday night at 8:30 Central Time on NETV.
Story time. We'll read the story about the big dog. Yes, on the way to school.
Always there when you need us. Nebraska Public Power District, together with your local public power utility.
Programming on NETV is provided in part by Bryan LGH Medical Center in Lincoln, nationally recognized by AARP for its work in orthopedics. Bryan LGH also received nationwide acclaim for its success in cardiovascular services. And the medical center has been recognized nationally for its support of working mothers. Bryan LGH, the first name in healthcare.
From the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, this is NETV.
It's Southeast and East, two rivals from the capital city doing battle for the Class A championship in two previous meetings this year, one at the district final. Lincoln East dominated the first half. Southeast rallied in the second, won in overtime 57-50. And then earlier in the regular season, it was again Lincoln Southeast 44-37. But will something finally give? Well, something's going to. Either Southeast is going to end this two-year losing streak in the state championship game, or Lincoln East is going to end a 15-year losing streak to Lincoln Southeast. Let's meet the Knights and the
Good
Spartans.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Bob Devaney Sports Center for the 2003 Girls Nebraska State High School Basketball Championships. For this afternoon's Class A championship game between the visitors, the Lincoln Southeast Knights, and the home team, the Lincoln East Spartans. Now for today's introductions. First, the non-starters for Lincoln Southeast, number 20, Lindsay Prefert. Number 22, Allison Jurgensen. Number 24, Cassie Drupal. Number 42, Becky Davis. Number 50, Megan Hill. Number 51, Allison Poole. And number 52, Jenna Hetchko. Now the non-starters for Lincoln East. Number 10, Annie Rice. Number 20, Rachel Schwartz. Number 30, Jenna Schultz. Number 34, Carly Poole. Number 40, Allison Ehlers. Number 44, Amanda Leitner. And number 52, Jennifer Bath. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineup for the Lincoln Southeast Knights. A 5'7" junior, number 30, Cassie McKinnon. A 5'5" senior, number 32, Tatum Feast. A 6'2" senior, number 40, Kim Schubert. A 5'9" junior, number 44, Jamie Loos. And a 5'8" senior, number 45, Gary Sufficool. The assistant coaches for the Knights are Paul Smith, Chris Johnson, Eric Graham, Stacy Zimmerly, and the head coach for Lincoln Southeast is John Larson. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the starting five for your Lincoln East Spartans. A 5'11" junior, number 12, Jenna Cole. A 5'9" junior, number 14, Sarah Sedlak. A 5'10" senior, number 22, Jenna Fostick. A 5'11" senior, number 24, Amy Reynoldson. And a 5'11" junior, number 32, Melissa Hinckley. The assistant coaches for the Spartans are John Strain, Greg Long, Tony Nestrick, and Jessica Jensen. And the head coach for Lincoln East is Todd Mitzmesser. Ladies and gentlemen, the officials for the Class A championship game are Mr. Brad Fetty and Jeff Graver. And the bench official is Donnie Mack.
Well, the Spartans wouldn't be doing that rotation dance had it not been for number 14 right there in the center of your picture, Sarah Sedlak, who hit the game-winning three. And yes, there was a little bit of controversy with that shot. The television replays show, Andrew, that the ball was not yet out of the hand against Omaha Westside, but it was a bang-bang call both ways. It was one of those could have gone either way, and in high school basketball, there is no instant replay.
You just about said it. All you can say right there, you can't really fault the referee, because if you really listen to it over and over again, it was before the horn, although the clock may have expired by a tenth of a second, but that's old news now.
And here we go, the Spartans and the Knights. Each of these two teams like to wear different uniforms. This is the third different uniform that Southeast wears. They have a gold-based uniform, a white-based uniform. They're going with the black today. Lincoln East, you know, if this were a football game, it'd be the Steelers and Cowboys. You got the silver and blue, and you got the black and gold. Two longtime rivals, but Lincoln East has been on the downside in this series. Haven't won since 88. Here's an open three. Or is that going to be two? It's going to be two for Cassie McKinnon.
And a dangerous shooter. All the Lincoln Southeast shooters are dangerous. She can knock it down. Jamie Loos can knock it down. And then Kerry Sufficool, the best three-point shooter for the Knights.
Southeast will back down into 2-3 zone defense. Lincoln Southeast has pitched a shutout in each of the last two first quarters here in the state tournament against Papillion-La Vista and Omaha Marion here last night. So Lincoln East trying to become the first team here in the state tournament to score against the Knights in the first quarter. An
Lincoln
amazing
East
stat.
Turnover.
Tatum Tease with the turnover. As she stood right in front of that pass, you try to reverse the ball against that zone, you got to be watchful of number 32. She may not be extremely tall. She's only 5'5", but she can get up in the air.
And I think she makes it all happen offensively, though. Doesn't average a lot of points, but she's really the rock, the best ball handler for the Knights.
McKinnon, who had the opening two. Kim Schubert playing outside of the post right now. Now she'll back it down in. Tease will take it up to the free throw line. And off the back of the iron, no good. Jenna Cole into the front court. She loves to run the ball down the floor between defenders. Dishes underneath. And it was last touched by Lincoln East. A little out of control. Melissa Hinckley, the last one to touch it. One thing about Lincoln East, and we even saw it on that game-winning shot two nights ago, it seems like the strategy of the Lincoln East offense, there isn't a pass that can't be made.
Exactly.
Sometimes they take that possession, and just when you think they're going to shoot, boom, a quick pass right there. You thought Cole was going to shoot. She tries to find Hinckley. That's their strategy.
Very unselfish, like you said. you know, never a bad pass for Lincoln East. More motion than any team in the state.
Tatum tees for three. And Lincoln Southeast is up 5-0.
I think talent-wise, you've got to go with Lincoln East, but the mental edge has got to be with Southeast.
They've been here before so many times it's hard to count. Their 12th state final. Their third in a row. Open three, Sedlak off the side of the iron. Yesterday, she made all but one three-pointer. She was 4 of 5. 5-0 Lincoln Southeast. Here's Schubert.
Oh, boy.
Boy, if Southeast, if Schubert's doing that, this game might as well be called right now because that's not her shot, and yet she still hit it from 18 feet.
And they have not had a huge offensive performance yet in this state tournament. East hoping it doesn't happen today.
Fosdick for Lincoln East, fouled by Schubert. She'll go to the line. It's been kind of a frustrating state tournament for Jenna Fosdick, the 5'10 senior who is the second leading scorer on this team with 12 points per game, but she was held to 7 points against Westside and just 5 points yesterday in more of a supporting role where she had to more distribute the basketball.
Exactly. I think last year Jenna Fosdick was more of an offensive threat. This year she's kind of had to learn to play with two emerging offensive threats by her side, and Jenna Cole and Melissa Hinckley, and play well with those players, John.
The foul was against Schubert, her first. And there's the first 2 points scored against Lincoln Southeast in the first quarter of a state tournament game this year. In fact, yesterday, Omaha Marion didn't score for the first 10 minutes and 50 seconds. And Southeast ran away with the semifinal victory. 7-2 Knights. Schubert. Tatum tees inside, outside. McKinnon will try the three.
Oh, man. They're red hot.
You know, and this is a stark contrast to the first 2 days. Even though Southeast got off to a great start offensively or defensively, their offense never really followed suit. They struggled mightily offensively. Here's Cole underneath. Nice dish by Cole. Boy, she can distribute the basketball. Reynoldson will go to the line. The talk right now is that Jenna Cole is going to be, if not one of the top, maybe even the top prospect of the junior class of this year, the senior class of next.
She's getting some serious looks from Nebraska. Connie Yori very interested in Jenna Cole, and you can see why. Yesterday, playing against the Goliath team of the tournament, Millard West, she absolutely took over the game when it counted. But this Lincoln East team, though, John, really the three-headed monster. You got Hinckley, you've got Cole, and then you've got Jenna Fosdick. Really three players that can play with anybody.
Amy Reynoldson with the first free throw. Reynoldson, 6-foot senior. Misses the second, 7-point Southeast lead. Coming up on the halfway mark to play first quarter, the Class A championship from the Bob Devaney Sports Center. Tatum Tees. This is Los. Now to Schubert. Again, playing outside the post. Thought about it from three and she traveled. Turnover against the Knights.
Boy, you can really feel the electricity, too. Nothing against D2 and C2, but there seems to be a little bit more life in this building right now.
It helps when you have a student population. There's over 2,000 kids that go to Southeast, and the student enrollment at East is about 1,600. That's more than the population of the two towns combined in the last game.
Little inside, tentative offensively.
Inside, outside. Cole lost it going out of bounds. Reynoldson tried to save it, and nothing doing there.
Now, this Southeast defense can be frustrating. You saw what they did yesterday to Omaha Marion's Andrea Lightfoot, and she's a Nebraska recruit, a Division I ball player, and they made her a non-factor in that ball game.
1 for 11 was Lightfoot yesterday. Marion shot 11% for the game. McKinnon, Schubert again outside the arc. Los. Nearly lost it and got it back. Southeast was set up again. Here's Tees. Little short. Schubert going for the rebound. Tie up Lincoln East basketball. 3 minutes, 13 seconds left. First quarter. Substitutions now coming in off Todd Mittmesser's bench. We'll see Jennifer Bath and Melissa Hinckley. Or Megan Hill, I beg your pardon. Megan Hill coming in for Lincoln Southeast. Spoke too soon there.
John, it's been a long year. Lincoln Southeast has had to think about that loss to Bellevue East last year. Came down to the final seconds. They just came up short. They want to make up for it today.
Fosdick for Bath and a foul. And I think that's going to go against the sophomore, Megan Hill, or the senior, Megan Hill. It will, her first. 13 foul against the Knights. Comes with 2:55 left in the first quarter. No shots, East will inbound. Fosdick, 5 second count is on. Lob it into Sedlak.
Southeast really looks unsure on how to attack this 2-3 zone. They're flashing Hinkley to the middle of the floor, but they can't get her the ball.
Look for Hinkley. Outside Schwartz. Lincoln East trying to find a way to break this Southeast defense. They punch it down low to Bath, rolls off the back of the iron, and the rebound to Kerry Suffacool of Lincoln Southeast.
Nice defense by Megan Hill. She's got the height advantage. Just stand tall and put up your hands and hold your ground.
You know, you watch the first two games at the state tournament, and you don't come away impressed with Southeast offense.
No.
But at least they started off pretty well there, and then there's contact on the rebound. And a travel is called. Incidental contact, traveling called on Lincoln East. Southeast seems to be able to adjust their tempo if they have to. If it has to be an offensive game, they'd rather it not. But if it has to be, they usually find a way to adjust. They would rather keep it low scoring and just beat you to death with their defense. Tease looks underneath for Hill. Turn around, fade away.
Nice, nice patience for Megan Hill. They got it down to her. She didn't have the shot, kicked it back out to Tease, and she went right back down to her. That's great basketball there.
Boy, this is a carbon copy of the last two nights. Southeast up by 9 here. The only difference is East actually has gotten on the scoreboard. Hinkley tries to take it through and traveled. Wasn't sure what she wanted to do with the basketball as you take a look at John Larson. And a timeout's coming up here with a minute 35 left in the first quarter. It's been all Southeast so far.
Hi, I'm Rick Steves. Join me for an exciting Ireland adventure. We'll visit thriving Dublin and mystical monasteries in the Wicklow Mountains. Throw glass and etch crystal at Waterford, bike the lush Dingle Peninsula, and enjoy some high-energy dancing through Galway. Together, we'll explore ancient and modern-day Ireland.
Coming March 16th at 6 Central Time on NETV.
And now, another digital bit with Bob Crangely.
Take regular TV, make it 6 times sharper and more detailed. Add CD-quality surround sound, and what have you got? High-definition television, or HDTV. It's another reason.
Digital TV on PBS isn't just a good idea. It's the future of television.
NETV is a service of the Nebraska Educational Telecommunications Commission.
We're back late first quarter, Southeast a 9-point lead. We're here with Liz Brendan, first-year head coach, Southwest girls basketball. Of course, you spent a lot of time at Southeast. What is the winning team going to have to do? What's going to decide it, coach?
Basically, tonight's going to come down to execution and the team that plays most consistently defensively. You know, keeping your key players, you know, Fosdick, Cole, Hinkley out of foul trouble for East. You know, for Southeast, they got to pound it in the shooter, knock down a couple of threes, but what it comes down to is consistency offensively and defensively.
Liz, with Coach Larson on the bench a lot of years, I know last year, obviously, we can't imagine the taste it left, but how does that help now the Knights in this game?
I think it's going to help a lot because they've been there, they've done that. This is their third year in a row they've played for the state championship. You know, granted, some of those players have gone and they're out of the program, but these guys, you know, they understand how to play and they're going to come out and execute and, you know, and do the best they can.
Liz, thanks for the time. Great job in your first year at Southwest. Of course, the Silverhawks are doing some nice groundwork academically and athletically. Fellas, back to you. Maybe Southwest could be one of those sights in the early rounds, John Drew, in this tournament in years to come. Back to you.
No doubt about it. Beautiful high school. And there's Hill again. Back-to-back field goals for her. And Southeast is up 11. And if there's anyone who knows how to play on this floor, it's Liz Brendan. Brendan, the former Husker, also has former Husker Nicole Kubik as an assistant. So I wouldn't be surprised to see the Silverhawks here in the near future. Lincoln Southeast right now just suffocating on the defense. They cannot get the ball to Jenna Cole. Cole has been a non-factor here in this first half. Cole nearly get the steal there. Southeast will play for the last shot here of the period, up by 11 over their rivals from Lincoln East.
And East up in the pressure a little bit, extending the defense outside.
Oh, wide open is Hill. And she missed it with one. That's going to count as it goes, but it does not. It has been all Lincoln Southeast, a smile by John Larson as we go to break. 8 minutes done. It's a football score right now, and when you know it, the football school's winning.
TV can be a child's window to the world. What will they see?
From the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, this is NETV.
Beginning of the second quarter, the defense of Lincoln Southeast, the story thus far, frustrating Lincoln East, and the Knights lead 14-3.
Try to get the pass to Hill. Smart play, she just backs it up. 14-3 Southeast. Here's Hill again. She has scored on three straight, not quite three straight possessions, but she's been responsible for the last 6 points. Couldn't get it there. Here comes Cole. Little out of control going through there, and a foul called on McKinnon. She had that ball down by her hip, and that was close.
John Larson likes to go with the big lineup. When he puts Megan Hill and Kim Schubert in the game at the same time, they're a little awkward offensively, but they make up for it on the defensive end because you've got two girls there that go about 6'2" apiece, and it makes it very difficult on any offense.
I'll tell you what's going to have to free up Southeast right now, and that's for Sedlak and Fosdick and even Cole to start shooting some threes here. Lincoln East down 14-3. All their points have come from the free throw line. No field goals yet for the Spartans. And they're just 0-2. They have gotten off two shots. There's the third. And Sedlak misses the three. Ball loose on the floor. Last touch by Southeast. That's amazing. Two field goal attempts in the first quarter.
Again, we talk about the mental edge going to Southeast. Todd Bidmesser, the coach of East, said after the first time his team played Lincoln Southeast, they said, okay, we think we can beat this team. And then after the second time, his team said, okay, we know we can beat this team, but yet both times, Southeast is winning the game. So it's a matter of doing rather than thinking for Lincoln East.
Annie Rice now in for Lincoln East. She's the one standing in the bottom right-hand corner. Here's an open three, and it's up, and it's good. It's Melissa Hinckley, and she's needed that. She's been on kind of a cold spell here at State.
And she did not play the last time these two teams played, and she was missed big time by the Spartans. They've got her back today.
14-6, first field goal by Lincoln East. 6:43 left before halftime. They reverse the ball out. They look underneath. Turnaround by Schubert in the lane. Yes, over the top of Hinckley.
Tell you what, when Schubert and Megan Hill post up on those blocks, they're pretty tough to contain, especially if you want to play man-to-man.
John Larson's offense is predicated around having someone like a Kim Schubert who is in there and can do those things. He's got an assistant coach on his bench, Kara Graham, that knows all about that. And a travel on Southeast. And that was a short rest for Jenna Fosdick, who will come back in. The senior averaging 11.9 points, 4.2 rebounds, but she's been held to just 12 points in this state tournament coming into today. She does have 2 points on two free throws. 16-6, Knights over the Spartans.
Help defense has just been outstanding. Anytime a Spartan gets by a Knight, watch the help. Somebody right there.
And she walked. That time, it was a nice move by Schwartz, at least to get Tease to commit and get around her. But as you mentioned, the help defense was there, and it also doesn't help when you travel with the basketball. Under 6 minutes to go, first half. 16-6 in favor of Southeast. This game going exactly as they want it. Southeast is a patient offensive team. You very rarely see them shoot the ball off of one or two passes. Schubert's going to go for the long range bomb.
Oh, nice.
And follows her shot.
There's the senior for you, Kim Schubert. Following her shot, not giving up on it, and that should not happen if you're Lincoln East. You got to block out.
They go down low to Bath. That time over the top of Schubert, and for one of the rare times, they're actually able to punch the ball underneath and not have two or three or four sets of hands flying in the way. Jamie Lohs. Schubert tries to go up top to Suffolk Cole, and it's taken away by Cole. Jenna Cole against four defenders, and it's stripped from behind. Nice recovery by Lohs as she stole it away.
Jamie Lohs saw that ball and tracked it down from beyond the half court.
And we're going to have a foul underneath, and it may go on either. It's either on Fosdick or on Bath. We'll see. It's going to be on Fosdick, yes. And perhaps that's in part the frustration of Jenna Cole. We'll talk about that when we come back from break with 4:47 left before halftime.
Live coverage of the 2003 State High School Basketball Championships is brought to you in part by
providing insurance and financial services. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Southeast Community College offers more than 40 technical and academic transfer programs and a variety of continuing education classes. There's no limit to what you can do with an education from SCC. The Nebraska Abstinence Education Program, working to prevent teenage pregnancy and the spread of sexually transmitted disease by promoting sexual abstinence until marriage.
Doan College was named a great school at a great price by U.S. News & World Report, offering undergraduate and graduate degrees at campuses in Crete and Lincoln. Teal Haas Tires, serving Nebraska since 1947. On the web at www.tealhaastire.com.
Hastings College, where the student comes first. www.hastings.edu.
The Class A championship has belonged to the Knights so far. Jenna Cole of Lincoln East not able to get on track. Jamie Lohs running her down from the backcourt, John.
And you saw four black jerseys, one gray jersey in that picture. Perhaps part of the frustration of Cole has not been able to get on track offensively, trying to do a little too much. In that case, Southeast, nice job of them getting back after the breakaway by Cole. But at the same time, Cole would have probably been better suited to back that thing out and try to set something up, because she was not going to win the numbers game there.
I think the story of this game so far is just how relaxed Lincoln Southeast has looked. I mean, they look like that they are supposed to be in this championship game. And this is a team that I thought going into districts was a little vulnerable, wasn't as strong as last year and as talented, but you just can't say enough about these seniors and what they've done.
Well, all you have to do is look at the guy sitting at the end of the bench, and that says it all. Yep. Right there. John Larson, a winner of over 400 games in his career, 7 state championships, 12 state championship game appearances. You can't say enough about what Larson has done for Lincoln Southeast girls basketball, and it's been a consistent system for a long time. Fosdick for three, and it rattles down.
That's nice. She stepped up and took that shot with confidence. That's what they need out of Jenna Fosdick, that feistiness and that daringness to take a shot like that.
Well, you mentioned early on that Fosdick's taken more of a less of a scoring role.
Yes.
In this team. Well, with her teammate Jenna Cole struggling right now, it might be time for Fosdick to step into the game and really try to do something offensively. But here comes Tatum Thies back to retaliate for the Knights. And now Southeast going to bring some pressure.
Anytime Lincoln East has made a little run, Southeast has responded right with them.
Hinkley inside, outside, open three for Cole. No. Rebound to Schubert.
And it's one shot and out for Lincoln East. They're not getting many second shots.
Southeast has led throughout. 3.5 to go in the first half. Wow, Tatum Tease. Tease, who scored just 10 points combined in the first two games, already has 9 here today. Here's Cole fighting hard underneath.
It's good for her to get her first bucket. Just get into the scorebook, and hopefully it'll trickle down to her teammates.
Coming up on 3 minutes to play in the first half, Knights still have a comfortable 11-point lead. Lose. Thies. Here's Schubert going up underneath on Bath. Scoop layup attempt missed, but a foul.
I asked John Larson, you know, what's it like to play a team for the third time, and how difficult is it to beat a team like Lincoln East three times? And he said, listen, I don't want to hear any of that. This is just another game for our ball club, and if we play our game, we know good things are going to happen. You said it. I mean, it's a great job him installing that mental toughness in this team. It's clear here in this first half.
And probably as good a sign of that came in the regular season finale when Southeast was upset by Norfolk on senior night. And Larson was very upset at his players, saying, you know, they were thinking more about senior night than they were about basketball. And he came out and said, we have to find some people who want to play basketball. I mean, this coming from a team that has won 20 games this year, and he's talking about the team as if, you know, they've been lackadaisical all season. It's that mental toughness that he knows he has to have, or else they're not going to make it very far. And here they are, up by 12 with 2:52 to go in the first half.
The legends of rhythm, blues, and soul unite for an event 40 years in the making to benefit public television.
Like to thank PBS for having this wonderful occasion.
Sunday night at 8 Central Time on NETV.
That's the news from Lake Wobegon. For all the women are strong, all the men are good-looking, and all the children are above average.
Saturdays at 5 Central Time on Nebraska Public Radio.
NETV is a service of the Nebraska Educational Telecommunications Commission.
Great to have you with us on a Saturday afternoon at Devaney Center. Game 3 of 6. Lincoln Southeast leads by 12 to 50. Left to go in the first half.
Into the front court comes Lincoln East. Jenna Fosdick looking for a teammate. Jenna Cole has to go to Hinckley instead. Hinckley trying to spin her way in on that defense. Opens up an open three, and here's Fosdick.
She wanted the ball that time. She clapped her hands, said, give me this ball. Let me take over this game.
25-16. That's a couple of threes now for Fosdick. Lose, another good three-point shooter for Southeast, goes inside to Hill. Hill had 6 points in the first quarter, misses there. Now Lincoln East trying to stake together a little bit of a run here. Sedlak, the Thursday night hero. Fosdick pulls up inside, short. Rebound to Lose.
Lincoln East, it looks like, has settled down from that early run.
Lose, wow. From the Big 12 logo. A 27-footer.
I don't know how happy John Larson is with that shot.
Jenna Cole to Sedlak. Minute 35 left before halftime. Spartans down by 9 here. Hinckley wants to go in. Now Fosdick's going to try to penetrate, fade away. No. Nice shot, though. Just a little too much English on the ball. Minute 18 left, first half. Open three. Just skimmed the rim by Jurgensen. Rebound to Cole. She wants to run. No. Coming in, and she carried the ball, and I'll tell you what happened there. Jurgensen forced the issue. She came screaming from behind. force Cole to go away that she didn't want to. Watch this. She got in her way. You might argue that that could be a foul, but either way, that was great heads-up play by Allison Jurgensen. Minute and eight left. Let's see what Southeast does here. They can want to press the issue, or if they want to take some time off the clock. Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touchdown. A nice play by Amy Reynoldson. You take a look at Todd Mittmesser, the head coach of Lincoln East. Very intense individual. He has done a marvelous job at Lincoln East since taking over 4 years ago. 6-14 his first year. 8-12 his second year. 11-8 last year, and now 16-4. Incremental progress every year. Timeout taken by Lincoln Southeast. They'll burn a 30 here. That's the first timeout used by the Knights in this game. Lincoln East still has all five of theirs. 52 and a half seconds left. And there's John Larson. As we mentioned, joined the 400 win club this year. 407 career victories for the man in the glasses there in the center of your screen.
And this team has had a lot of things to deal with off the court. Of course, the 400th win, and Kim Schubert, a state scholar athlete. They had the big senior night, the loss on senior night. They've kept it together this year, and this is a team, too, that very disappointed. A lot of these girls play volleyball. They did not get to the state championship. That's one of the most disappointing things any of these athletes will tell you. They want to make up for it here.
Southeast will inbound here. 52.7 seconds left here in the first half. It's been all Lincoln Southeast here so far.
A lot of pressure, though, being number one all season in volleyball, number one all season in basketball. Takes a lot to withstand that, all the media attention as a high school kid. To stay on top, it's not easy.
Tried to reverse the ball out, bad pass. Cole takes it away. East back the other way. Here's Cole through the lane, between defenders, fouled. Five Southeast players right there within 5 feet of Jenna Cole, but the senior, or the junior, I beg your pardon, going right in there, taking it tough. That's her game.
Exactly.
We kind of chastised her a little bit earlier on when she may have backed it out, but that time she thought she had it, and granted, she was going right through the center of the lane, so she knew either she was going to draw a foul and make the shot, or both.
She has such a nice stroke at the free throw line. Oh. Great, great fundamentals. I mean, you can see why, as a junior prospect, probably the hottest prospect in the state of Nebraska next year.
She is a good basketball player. And this is as close as Lincoln East has been for quite some time. It's 25-18, 28.6 seconds left. You see Annie Rice come in for East High School.
East has been clawing back, trying to just get back. You want to stay under 10 before the half. They can't allow a three here for Southeast. You know they're probably going to look for one.
Ooh, a near steal there inside Schubert. Kind of off balance. Rebound to Lincoln East and a foul by Hill. Ooh. And that was a mistake. John Larson throwing his hands up. He says, look at the time. A rare mistake by Schubert, who went in. You literally, that's what he's saying. He's saying, why shoot it so early?
Clock management, so yeah. Important. We saw it in the last game. A few of the players didn't get their shots off before the time expired. You got to have clock awareness. Know when to hold for the last shot, when to take your last shot, when it's inside the final seconds.
Rice comes out, Sedlak back in. Don't be surprised if they try to free up number 14 for a three here. 10 seconds left. East down by seven. Second quarter action. They'll go inside. Cole in there. No. Rebound to Southeast, and that's the way this half will end. First quarter belonged to the Knights. Second quarter, Lincoln East has fought back to within seven. We're at halftime of the Class A state championship game with your score, Lincoln Southeast 25, Lincoln East 18. I have a feeling we're in for a pretty doggone good second half of basketball when we get that to that action. Right now, let's go down courtside with Kyle D'Elia.
Coach Larson, Southeast, you got to be happy, I'm sure, the way that defense gave you baskets and they executed. But now how do you keep the Spartans out of the game?
Well, we lost track of a couple three-point shooters there, and they gave them too many open looks. We got to do a little bit better job there. And I thought we got in too big a hurry, a couple possessions on offense. But otherwise, we're playing pretty good. We just got to, you know, continue it for 16 more minutes.
Go get with your kids. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Coach John Larson, his Lincoln Southeast team leading 25-18 at the break.
Come back, join our fellas who are doing one fine job. We're halftime. Class A state basketball on 1011 and NETV.
Hi, everybody. I'm Rod Bates, general manager of NET, and this is a scheduled timeout during the basketball game, and you're not going to miss a moment of basketball action. Right now, I'd like to encourage you not to miss out on this opportunity to become a member of Nebraskans for Public Television. Why is this a critical time to join? Because of current economic stress, number one, and because we want to preserve this statewide treasure. So call us now at 1-800-676-5446, and when you call, we'll offer you one of the following member benefits. If you join now at the $60 level, we'll send you the NETV coffee mug. At $90, you'll receive this sturdy, insulated NETV coffee mug for your car or office. And on your way to the office, carry your own NETV tote bag, yours with a membership at $120. At the $240 level, we'll send you a unique, high-quality denim shirt with the NETV logo, handsomely embroidered in red. That's $20 a month at the $240 level. And of course, with every membership at $60 or more, you're going to receive the NPTV PRNF membership card. Members receive special benefits from organizations and businesses throughout the state. You'll also receive a discount on program-related products at our online member store. All you do is log on at mynptv.org/members, and you can use this secure site to select your membership level and your member benefits. Call 1-800-676-5446. Now let's get you back to the Devaney Sports Center and the high school basketball finals. Thanks for your pledge.
Monday night at 7 Central Time on NETV.
Public radio does over the airwaves what I try to do in the airwaves in the concert hall. It's that communication of this language, which is a musical language. It's different than spoken language, but it is a language nonetheless. It's not just an entertainment aspect, it's an educational and enlightening aspect that's very important. That's what we are, we're educators.
From the University of Nebraska, Lincoln, this is NETV.
The Apollinaires of Lincoln East performing at halftime as Lincoln Southeast leads Lincoln East 25-18 at halftime of the Class A girls final. The 10-11 coaches all-state team dominated by the Metro Conference. Two Westside Warriors, two Millard West Wildcats, and an Omaha Marion Crusader. You can't argue with some of the choices on that list because all of these athletes are fine basketball players. You have Katherine Anderson going to Denver University. Jamie Chapman's going to end up playing at Indiana. Haley Fries isn't even going to play basketball. She's going to go to UNO on a soccer scholarship. And we talked about Andrea Lightfoot, the Nebraska recruit. You throw in Lauren Gustafson, who averages nearly 18 points a game. And you can see, even though the two teams in this game are not from Omaha, there were still a lot of talent, not only in Omaha and Lincoln, all throughout Class A.
You could have made a case for Kim Schubert. You could have made a case for Jenna Cole. Those girls could have gotten consideration on that team, but take nothing away from that team. A great group of basketball players there, and so a lot of big players too, and Katherine Anderson's one of them.
Well, Katherine Anderson and Jamie Chapman, each 6'3", they really command a presence underneath, and Haley Fries, who did everything but put Omaha Westside into the semifinals with her performance in the quarterfinals. It was indeed a good year for Class A girls basketball in the state of Nebraska. 25-18 is our score. Lincoln Southeast with a 7-point lead over Lincoln East High, and we'll be back with the stats in a moment.
This month, Nebraska connects you and taxes.
I'm Mike Tobias, and NETV will help you get through tax season. Join us on Thursday, March 27th at 7 Central for tax tips. We'll have tax experts in our studio ready to take your phone calls and give you the advice you need. This tax season, be more prepared as we connect you with the experts with tax tips. Thursday, March 27th at 7 Central Time, live on NETV.
Hi, I'm LeVar, and I know many of you are already busy creating your very own original book for the Reading Rainbow Young Writers and Illustrators Contest. And for those of you who haven't entered yet, there's still time for you to get your entries in. Remember, this contest is open to everyone in kindergarten through third grade. So hurry up and start writing for the chance to win some great prizes. I'm looking forward to reading your entries.
Entry forms and rules are on our website at mymptv.org or call 1-800-698-3426 or if you live in Lincoln, 472-7067. Mail your entries to Reading Rainbow Contest, MS 11, NETV, P.O. Box 83111, Lincoln, Nebraska, 68501. Entries must be postmarked by Friday, March 14th.
NETV is a service of the Nebraska Educational Telecommunications Commission.
While the NSAA's Believers and Achievers are saluted at halftime of the Class A Girls Championship game, let's take a look at the first half stats from this title contest. Lincoln Southeast with a 7-point lead. You can see the field goal percentage is about even. East getting off 10 shots in that quarter. They only had 2 field goal attempts in the first quarter of this basketball game. Individually, for Lincoln Southeast, Tatum Thies with 9 points. Kim Schubert has 7. 5 points for Cassie McKinnon and 4 for Megan Hill. For Lincoln East, Jenna Fosdick has 8 points. 4 points for Jenna Cole. 3 points for Melissa Hinckley. 2 for Jennifer Bath and 1 for Amy Reynoldson. Halftime score, Lincoln Southeast 25, Lincoln East 18. And in the second half, we'll see which one of these two teams can make it all the way. The Knights going for their 8th state championship, the Spartans their 3rd.
My name is Ann Sherwood. Ann spelled with me.
It's a name Green Gables will never forget. Join this imaginative little girl on adventures filled with laughter, tears, and plenty of mischief. Don't miss Ann of Green Gables.
Sunday morning at 11 Central Time on NETV.
Well, it's been a quiet week in Lake Wobegon, my hometown. This portion of our show brought to you by Powder Milk Biscuits.
Do you want to spend the winter here, or don't you?
That's the news from Lake Wobegon, where all the women are strong, all the men are good-looking, and all the children are above average.
A Prairie Home Companion, Saturdays at 5 Central Time on Nebraska Public Radio.
They came in search of a golden dream. An ancient culture in a new world. Through triumphs and setbacks, struggles and success, their story is our story.
I am an American, but I have to become an American to everybody else.
Bill Moyers presents Becoming American, The Chinese Experience, premieres March 25th, only on PBS.
From the University of Nebraska, Lincoln, this is NETV.
Williams. Southeast by 7 as we're getting ready for second half action here at the Girls State Basketball Tournament. We talked about during the All-State teams how Class A was a very good, solid field this year. And coming into this game, as Andrew mentioned during the first half, how Lincoln Southeast had been number one for most of the season. Actually, Papillion La Vista started the year as the state's number one team. At the end of the regular season, because of that Norfolk upset over Southeast, the Knights actually dropped to 3rd, but eventually made it. Norfolk did not make it to state. Bellevue East lost out and did not get a chance to make it to state, but pretty much everyone who was expected to be here got here, and you know, obviously you could make an argument that Marion is worthy of being in the championship game, how Millard West, but we have two pretty good representatives here here this afternoon. Let's go down now courtside with Kyle D'Elia, find out what Todd Mittmesser has in mind for the Spartans in the second half.
Thanks, John. Drew, Coach, you reinforced your kids the confidence, hey, we're the comeback Spartans in the locker room.
Well, the kids know we can do this, so certainly that was talked about. But we just need to keep the intensity up like we had in the second quarter. We didn't come out defensively the way we needed to, and we made some adjustments, and that's working well right now. And that's helped get us into some transition offensively also. And we're doing a better job in the second quarter there of attacking the basket. We made some other adjustments, so we're going to continue with some of those things that we did in the second quarter, and I think we can do it.
Real quick, what did you say to your kids, or what kind of adjustments you're looking to carry out?
Well, offensively, we've got to keep attacking the basket with a dribble and making some cuts, some movement with some people, and that's going to get us into some openings. We stood around way too much in the first quarter.
Go get with your Lady Spartans. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Kyle.
Good luck to the Spartans and, of course, the Knights in the second half. We're coming back with a second half thriller. Lincoln Southeast 25-18 after one. Don't go away. We got championship basketball, 10-11 and NETV.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
He needs no introduction.
I hear the train a-coming. It's rolling around the bend.
He's one of country and rock music's greatest entertainers.
I don't know when.
Life ain't easy for a boy named Sue.
Join us as we pay tribute to the man in black.
It's that orange blossom special, bringing my baby back.
Don't miss Johnny Cash, the anthology.
Tuesday night at 10:30 Central Time on NETV.
And now, another digital bit with Bob Frankley.
With digital TV, we can either broadcast one high-definition show or divide up the signal and broadcast several different PBS shows at the same time. It's called multicasting, and it's another reason...
Digital TV isn't just a good idea, it's the future of television.
From American experience, more than any other artist of the century, he would help transform the meaning of wilderness in America. He first encountered the power and beauty of the American landscape when he was just 14. He would spend the rest of his life trying to capture it on film. Ansel Adams, on American Experience.
Coming March 24th to NETV.
From the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, this is NETV.
Lincoln Southeast with a 25-18 win over the It's not there yet. Halftime lead over the Lincoln East Spartans. John Bishop, Andrew Felios here courtside. Kyle D'Elia roaming the sidelines, keeping tabs on things down there and talking to our coaches, doing a fine job down there. And we'll also hear from him after the game with today's runner-up coach. Andrew, if I can get it out of my mouth, what are these teams going to have to do to avoid being interviewed by Kyle as a runner-up coach after today's game?
Well, I think Liz Brennan, the coach for Lincoln Southwest, in her prior interview with Kyle said it best, and that the team that plays most consistently throughout this game is going to win. Both teams have had their little spurts. Lincoln East also, I thought Todd Mittmesser touched on a good point when he said we have to get more movement in our offense. A lot of times, Lincoln East, the girls were kind of standing around watching each other, and you can't have that happen in a championship game. Meanwhile, Lincoln Southeast definitely looked like the more relaxed team, the more experienced team that was supposed to be here in the first half. So if East can up the intensity, they'll be okay. Southeast just got to keep doing what they're doing.
And I don't want to make it sound like it's a bad thing to be interviewed by Kyle, but let's face it, after the game, you don't want to be interviewed by Kyle because he's the one in charge of interviewing the run-up coaches. So I want to make that clarification. We're not trying to keep people away from you, Kyle. We just understand what your role is here after the games today. 25-18 is our score. Lincoln Southeast with the lead over Lincoln East. You take a look at the Southeast Pep Band. You know, if they gave out state championship trophies for Pep Bands, I think Southeast would be right in and amongst them. They play some of the best variety of music I've ever heard out of a high school or college Pep Band.
Oh, we had them in our studio early in the year to shoot a promo, and they are really something else. And how about the dance teams at the half? Two quality dance teams, both just great schools here. This is just a great atmosphere.
Yeah, it is. And you take a look at the Lincoln East Band. They, too, do a fine job. You know, there's about as much competition in the musical field in this town as there is in the athletic field. I know the band directors really enjoy trying to put on a good show for the fans, both in football, volleyball, basketball, and everywhere that they play, including their band competitions. And that's just one of those things about the state tournament you love. You love to hear the bands. You love to hear the different variety of what people do. And it all comes together, east, west, north, south, central, it doesn't matter. They're all here at the state tournament to watch their teams try to go all the way.
Such a pivotal quarter, as it is going to be through every game today. East needs a good start.
And here we go. Lincoln East has cut the lead down to 7. This is as close as they've been since the opening minutes of this basketball game. A look inside for Cole. Nice underhand dish underneath. Maybe waited just a little bit too long to go up to the basket, but Hinckley does draw the foul. Had Hinckley gone up a little bit more aggressive early on, she might have been able to get an easy 2. Instead, she'll go to the line, but does draw the foul. We should mention that foul trouble, it's almost non-existent, at least so far, something that Southeast has not had the luxury of these last two games. The foul is on Schubert. It's her second. Nobody in this game has more than 2 fouls, so we're in pretty good shape personnel-wise going into the second half.
But, you know, fouls can be a factor. You saw yesterday Nicole Wilson of Lincoln Christian pick up like 3 fouls in, what was it, like a minute and 30 seconds?
Yeah.
So it can happen in a hurry. You have to play safe.
25-19. Lead is down to 6. Schubert again playing outside of the arc. Lose will get the pick and the 3. No. Got a good screen, though. And had an open look down the floor. Hinckley to the baseline. Tried to bounce pass parallel to the baseline, and Teese kicked it out of bounds with her foot. 25-19. Spartans trying for their, not only their first state title since 87, their first win over Lincoln Southeast since 1988. And Southeast trying to avoid becoming just the second school in girls' state tournament history to lose 3 straight times in the finals. Pius X was a victim of it back in the late 80s.
I think a big challenge for Jenna Cole, you know, she's listed as a point guard, but has to guard the biggest player on the floor in Kim Schubert. So it just gives you an idea of her versatility.
Foul was on Jenna Cole. That's her second. So the two of the bigger players in this game, Schubert and Cole, each now with 2 fouls. Tie-up is called. Possession arrow to Lincoln Southeast. Todd Mittmesser, young head coach of the Spartans in his 4th year, as we talked about in the first half, incremental progress each year that he has been at 70th and A Street.
And he's a very intense guy to be around, really takes pride in his basketball team.
In fact, yesterday, as we have a near steal in the backcourt, or front court, I should say, as Schubert tries to go strong underneath, she's fouled from behind. She'll go to the line and shoot a couple here. And that foul's going to be on Cole. And that's her 3rd. So just as you mentioned, Andrew, it doesn't take long to start racking up fouls. And now Cole has 3. And it looks like Todd Mittmesser is going to bring in Amy Reynoldson in her place here at the buzzer. Schubert misses the first. Schubert with 12 points against Papillion La Vista, 14 yesterday against Marion. Just the second free throw she has missed as you take a look at Cole going off the court.
And you think John Larson knows that Jenna Cole had 2 fouls the last 2 trips down. He went right into Kim Schubert on the blocks.
Makes the second, lead is up to 7 again. Well, Fosdick, who's with the basketball right now, she kind of was the catalyst that sparked that second quarter run by the Spartans that brought this game closer. It's going to be up to her now to start to shoulder some more of this burden. There she is, wants the ball for 3. Little bit short, offensive board, basket foul, and count it.
And more importantly, that's going to be the 3rd on Schubert. So racking up fouls in the hurry. Jenna Cole for East, but now Kim Schubert. You watch the missed shot.
And And actually, they're going to get
Suffolkul.
They're going to get Suffolkul with the foul, but you're right, it was close. But a nice play by Amy Reynoldson. But she misses the chance at a three-point play, and the lead is still five. 6 minutes, 23 seconds. You see the clock, lower left hand of your screen. They try to punch it inside. Here's Lohse. And the rebound to Reynoldson. Boy, is she going to have to come up big. Amy Reynoldson, the six-foot senior, try to battle in there and get some rebounds. Hinkley thought about it from three. Now they'll go around the perimeter.
Hinkley has not been able to shake free, but there's an open shot.
Sedlak, the hero of Thursday night, with her first two of the second half, and it's down to a three-point lead.
You can feel the momentum shifting. Lincoln East, the student body on their feet. They haven't had much to cheer about to this point.
Ah, but a great answer by Carrie Suffolkul. I was about to say, this is as close as any team has been to Southeast in the second half of any state tournament game. Fosdick went through the lane and was fouled.
And a note on Suffolkul, you know, it always seems like she's a second-half player. It seems like every time the Knights need a three in game down the stretch, she's always there to deliver this season.
And we'll see if she's here for this one. Suffolkul, 7 points yesterday, 11 on Thursday. Second foul. I believe they called that. I thought they called it on Tatum Thies. They have McKinnon up there on the board for the foul.
Oh,
nice, tough, underhand scoop layup by Hinkley. And it's down to 4 points again.
There's the talent of Melissa Hinkley standing out. Clearly had no shot at the basket, but was able to scoop it in over the biggest player on the floor.
A look inside. Lohse takes it up strong, blocking foul. And now they are starting to send Jamie Lohse through the center of that Lincoln East defense. She's been very quiet so far in this game. First foul on Sarah Sedlak. Lohse has not checked into the scoring column yet. She had 11 points yesterday, including a pair of threes. They look inside for Schubert, but the pass was even too tall for her.
Very active defensively.
Spartans have been more aggressive here in the second half. Near travel. Tried to back it up with the pass, and it was taken away. Taken away by McKinnon. And Fosdick showing the frustration on her face as she sprints by. Spartans within four, but the Knights have the basketball. Coming up on the halfway mark here in this third quarter, Class A championship from the Devaney Center. Dribble baseline penetration. Tried the reverse layup. She was rejected by the bottom of the backboard by Jamie Lohse.
Oh, boy. Tough call.
4 minutes, 28 seconds left, and now a substitution for Lincoln Southeast. Megan Hill, who had an impact on a couple of possessions in the first half, now in there, and here again is that taller lineup.
That's right, Megan Hill, the Kansas volleyball recruit, and when she checks into the game with Schubert, it just causes a lot of problems. John Larson going back to that lineup because East is on a run.
And Schubert draws the foul from Reynoldson. Fouls are starting to rack up a little bit here. It was a relatively cleanly played first half. If I pull out the stat sheet from the first half, just 9 combined fouls in the first 16 minutes. We haven't played 4 minutes yet. We already have 7. And Schubert has gone cold at the charity stripe. She is 2 for 5.
A lot of people wondered how Schubert would do with the departure of J.J. Smith and how she would take over the role of being the center of attention on this team. She's done a fabulous job this season. Can't ask for a much better year.
And now Southeast is coming with pressure. Fosdick didn't get much help from her teammates, and Lincoln East is forced to use a timeout. 30-second timeout taken by the Spartans. That's their first timeout that they have used in this game. 4:15 left, third quarter.
The harmonies, the memories,
I started a joke.
The Bee Gees, one night only.
Monday night at 8:30 Central Time on NETV. NETV is a service of the Nebraska Educational Telecommunications Commission.
The Class A championship has turned into a fabulous basketball game. Lincoln East trails Southeast by 5, 4:15 left. Third quarter, Southeast sets up in the full court press.
But the Spartans break it. Melissa Hinckley stands with it at center court. Spartans have been as close as 3 here in the second half. They have never led. Oh, tried the bounce pass. Tried to feed it into Reynoldson, and there was nobody there except black and gold. Schubert, move in a little closer and swish.
And that makes it tough, too, because you saw the double team on Megan Hill down on the blocks, but you got to get out and guard Schubert, too. She's shown the ability to hit that long-range shot today.
Oh, nearly a dangerous pass by Fosdick. Nice poise by Hinckley to keep it alive for the Spartans, who are now down by 7. A look inside. Turnaround by Fosdick. Short. Ball tipped around. Sedlak falling in there amongst the trees. Gets it. Needs help. Backs it up. They tried to go under there, and Schwartz was moving in fast, but didn't have the ball in the right spot. Todd Mittmesser goes to his bench. Remember, Jenna Cole not in there. She is on the bench with 3 fouls. You have to wonder, at what point do you bring her back in this game? Because, as you mentioned, there's kind of a magic barrier at 10, and now an outlet pass down the floor, and they can't quite connect. Nice idea, but McKinnon could not catch up to the pass. But you mentioned that 10-point barrier. When Southeast gets you by 10, that's when they really start to clamp down on you, and you don't want it to get to that point.
And I think you're right. At what point do you bring back Jenna Cole? I think Melissa Hinckley's shown the ability to guard Kim Schubert. So with that, I think, you know, you could probably bring back Jenna Cole a little sooner, because just let another player guard Kim Schubert.
And just as we start talking about it, Cole goes to the scorer's table, and she will check in at the next whistle. Melissa Hinckley. Sedlak trying to free herself up. Tease has done a nice job guarding her today. To try to get it underneath, Hinckley throws up a desperation shot.
She's a big-time player.
Well, even the best players need to have a little luck now and then. 5-point lead. Ball was tipped by Hinckley. They still get it into Schubert. Off the back iron, no good, but she'll go to the free throw line and shoot 2.
Southeast really has the height advantage. You can see down low. I mean, they can punch it down to Schubert and get a shot basically any time they want. So it's going to be interesting to see. Jenna Cole's getting ready to check back in the game. Will she guard Kim Schubert, or will they continue to let somebody else guard her, like Melissa Hinckley or Sarah Sedlak?
Schubert now 4 of 7 at the free throw line, 12 points, leading all scorers in this game. Sedlak comes out and Cole comes in. That may have answered your question. Misses the second. Bath with the rebound for Lincoln East. Down by 6 here. 2 minutes, 18 seconds left here in the third quarter. Cole takes it all the way into the corner. Nice move by Hinckley underneath. Ooh, tried to get the pass to Bath. Ball loose on the floor. Tie up. Lincoln East will keep possession.
Lincoln East,
well, it's one of those where that extra pass might have hurt, because depending on what kind of move Hinckley has, she might have been able to try to reverse layup.
Yeah, Bath did not expect the pass that time. Hinckley was trapped underneath the goal, tried to get it to her. Could not, but they keep possession.
Look underneath, threw it away. Again, tried to punch it down low to Bath. I think they're looking to try to get that 4th foul on Schubert. But so far, it's been East misfiring.
And number 24, Amy.
And as you see, it looks like Jenna Cole. Okay, I'm just interested to see who she's going to guard on this play. I think they may even put her on Tatum Thies, the point guard. Got to keep her out of where she'll be prone to pick up that 4th foul. They cannot afford that to happen.
Lincoln East trying to trap now. They break the 10-second count. Thies trying to get it underneath. Ball was rejected in. Thies got it back. Thies needs to get it away. does. 5 second count was on. Southeast keeps it. Southeast a little more deliberate now on the offensive side. Tease has Cole on her. Tease takes it in on Cole, stops. Tried to go back door to McKinnon, but she wasn't open. Southeast taking their time, rejected by Fosdick, taken away by Lincoln East. Fosdick trying to weave her way through the traffic. Open shot on the way, no, by Rachel Schwartz, and the rebound to Lincoln Southeast. East a little impatient on the offensive side. 1 minute to go for third quarter. Southeast has led from the very beginning.
Southeast trying to work it inside. Not much has changed in their game plan. There's the steal.
And Cole just about had the steal, but stepped on the sideline.
What I like about Southeast is you don't see a player really try and do something that she can't do. You know, everybody kind of just plays their role. Megan Hill comes off the bench. She knows her role. Tatum Thies knows her roles to run the team and take the opportunity when it's there. They try and get the ball inside. Such a well-coached team.
Could get an over and back here. No, it was last touch by East, they say. Oh, my, that was close. That looked like an over and back. They say it touched off of Lincoln East's leg. Tried the entry pass in, and a foul's going to be called on Amy Reynoldson. And that is the sixth team foul against the Spartans. Just three on Lincoln Southeast. Kind of reversal of fortune for the Knights. Six-point Southeast lead. 5 second count is on. They get it in. Lose will take it in baseline, and nobody was there. And the lead is back up to eight.
First bucket for Lose. Finally gets on the scoreboard. It took a while, but she's finally happy to be on the board.
15 seconds left in the quarter. Lincoln East needs some points here. Down by eight. A look underneath. Cole, underhand dish. Blocked by Schubert. And they call the foul.
She'll pick up her third just 5 seconds before the third quarter.
Third, you're right.
That's a tough.
I was about to say fourth. Right. I thought it was fourth.
Well, Suffolk who got whistled for that one on that.
That's right. You're right. That's what I was thinking. So to the free throw line is Amy Reynoldson. Reynoldson with 3 points today. Friendly roll here. Just 5.5 seconds left.
Annie Rice
will come in. They don't want Fosdick to pick up a cheap foul here in the last stages of this quarter. She only has one, but preserve as much of her as you can. Second foul shot. Good. 35-28. Pressure in the backcourt, and they call the foul.
Oh, no. That's on Jenna Cole, too. That's going to be number four.
Nope, it's
no,
not.
Okay.
It's on Schwartz.
Oh, that's a relief.
Boy, that would be a bad way to get a foul in the last 5.5 seconds of a quarter to put your star player in the foul trouble with four, but that's not the case. The foul is on Schwartz, her first. Seven fouls now on East, and that means a 1-1 for Tatum Thies. Misses the front end of the 1-1. Ball loose. Tees gets it up at the buzzer, but no. Southeast leads by seven as we go to the fourth quarter of the Class A championship game.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three.
Hi, I'm Rick Steves. Join me for an exciting Ireland adventure. We'll visit thriving Dublin and mystical monasteries in the Wicklow Mountains. Throw glass and etch crystal at Waterford, bike the lush Dingle Peninsula, and enjoy some high-energy dancing through Galway. Together, we'll explore ancient and modern-day Ireland.
Coming March 16th at 6 Central Time on NETV.
Hi, I'm LeVar Burton. In uncertain times, there's no more effective way to make your kids feel good and safe than to spend time with them. We at Reading Rainbow suggest sharing a book with your family. Read for fun, read for family, read for our future.
NETV encourages you to share a story with a child today. From the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, this is NETV.
entering the fourth quarter, Lincoln Southeast, a leader over Lincoln East by 7, 35-28. This has been a back-and-forth ball game. The third meeting between these schools, Lincoln Southeast won the previous two. Lincoln East hoping to get the one that counts this afternoon.
Southeast has the ball to start this second half, and underneath, Megan Hill. Her first point since the first half, and it's up to a 9-point Lincoln Southeast lead. Bostic, yes.
Jenna Bostic.
They are gonna need her in this fourth quarter, something fierce.
They certainly are. She's gotta be more assertive here in this final quarter. She's gotta get on the same page with Colin Hinckley.
A wide open three by Lohs. And I do mean wide open, but she missed it. East again, back in the offensive end. Oh, she lost it underneath. Throws up a shot, no. Long rebound though, tipped out to Lincoln East. Shot is up, good by Melissa Hinckley, and they put together a little run here and cut it to five.
Lincoln Southeast is gonna be pushed to the limit. This is not gonna be easy here. 5-point lead, it's been trimmed to under seven to go.
It's been as close as three in the second half, but that was quickly erased. Taking it in strong and a blocking foul. I think they're gonna get Reynoldson with it. They are. That's her third. Here's Kim Schubert to the free throw line. She's already attempted eight today. She's 4 of 8. Schubert with 12 points.
I think if you're John Larson, you gotta be happy right now. I mean, Jenna Cole yesterday dominated Millard West, put him up for 28. Right now, she's only got 4 points. Has not been much of a factor in this game.
Gotta make your free throws though, John Larson. Not liking what he sees out of Schubert at the line. Here's Cole, a little off balance underneath. And the rebound to Hill. And her struggles continue. Cole is just 1 of 6 from the field. Big difference from yesterday when she was 7 of 12, including 12 of 17 at the free throw line. Hill picks it up strong, draws a foul and count it.
Megan Hill. I tell you what, we have covered Lincoln Southeast all year long. We've seen spurts, but never post moves like that. That's out of the book of James Worthy right there. She got it, spun to the hole, put it up, and won.
Megan Hill, averaging 5 points, nearly 5 rebounds, has played a whale of a game here, has 8 today, and try to get the lead back up to 8 points. Can't convert on the 3-point play. Rebound to Reynoldson. Lincoln Southeast bringing the pressure again. Into the front court, the Spartans. We break under 6 minutes to play. Ooh. Big push underneath. Reynoldson goes crashing to the floor.
Fouls at number 50, Megan Hill, her third personal foul.
That's her third.
Against Lincoln Southeast.
She and Schubert each with 3, but that's not a terrible situation to be in. That's the 15th foul against the Knights. Hinckley in traffic. Look at her, tough move.
Man.
Melissa Hinckley has answered the bell today. She's got 12 to lead all Spartan scorers.
Fearless underneath. She's battling amongst a couple of girls that are 6'2". She's undersized down there, but she's not backing down.
Oh, hook pass for Schubert, and Jenna Fosdick can't believe the call. She thought she had a clean strip.
Well,
let's see it again. Yeah, it looked like she got her on her arm. And then Fosdick has some friendly words and a smile for the official who made the call, Jeff Graber of Fremont. First foul shot rolls in.
It's obvious what Lincoln Southeast wants to do these final minutes. They want to get the ball inside. They've done that successfully to Megan Hill. Kim Schubert has been down there drawing fouls, making a living at the free throw line. It's not a bad formula when you have two players that run about 6'2 apiece.
Fosdick now off the floor. Sedlak is in for Lincoln East. Misses the second. 40-34. Lincoln Southeast by six.
Got to look down court. Got open players down court.
Now they find him. They're going to be able to get him in time. Oh, made the pass. And again, sometimes you run yourself into trouble. Lincoln East almost passed their way out of a win on Thursday night. Right there, almost passed their way out of a possession. 5:25 left in this one. Southeast by six.
My name is Ann Sherman. Ann's spelled with me.
It's a name Green Gables will never forget. Join this imaginative little girl on adventures filled with laughter, tears, and plenty of mischief. Don't miss Anne of Green Gables.
Sunday morning at 11 Central Time on NETV.
Spinning around together on a planet of the sun.
We're all together, right, Big Bird?
Yes, Elmo.
Funding is provided in part by the Dr. Thomas and Dorothy Hallstrom Fund, created to support broadcasting of the Nebraska State High School Basketball Tournament.
From the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, this is NETV.
Fourth quarter of this Class A championship, Lincoln East chopping away at that Southeast lead, but so far the ice that is Southeast has not been able to break.
Sedlak had an open three, didn't take it. Turnaround move blocked by Schubert. East wanted the hack, didn't get it. Schubert gets the block. 5:12 left to play. They look for Schubert. Back it up. Now Schubert will come out of the post. Goes in on Reynoldson and draws the foul and counts the basket.
She has stepped up to the challenge, playing maybe the best game that she has this year, Kim Schubert. I mean, she's hit shots from the outside. She's driving to the hole. She's hit the shots inside that she's supposed to hit. I mean, she's made a living at the free throw line. She's done it all for Southeast today.
Foul is on Fosdick, her third. But again, second straight time they've had a chance at a three-point play and don't get it. Now Cole back in the game and draws the foul as she drew a double team from McKinnon and Tease. And I think they get McKinnon with the foul. Yes. So you have Fosdick with three and Cole with three. You have Schubert with three fouls for Lincoln Southeast. Knights in that zone defense. Open three for Fosdick. No. Rebound fought for. Jump ball called. Southeast basketball.
Lincoln East basketball.
4:40 left. You've got to start making your push right now. You cannot afford. It is Lincoln East basketball. Scoreboard says possession arrow to Southeast. So I beg your pardon. East keeps it. Sedlak, boy, the hero from Thursday night. Haven't heard much from her. Haven't heard much from this young lady either. Cole, fadeaway, tough. Oh, boy, was she hounded. And Todd Mittmesser takes a quick timeout. He'll burn a 30 here with 4:24 left. 42-36 is our score. 4:24 left to play. We'll be back.
Monday night at 7 Central Time on NETV.
In childhood, there are a lot of things that can be scary. Every day on PBS Kids, we help children face the challenges of growing up, one step at a time. Imagine the possibilities, PBS Kids and you.
NETV is a service of the Nebraska Educational Telecommunications Commission.
Lincoln East star Jenna Cole been quiet for most of the afternoon, but able to get this shot to go over Kim Schubert, and immediately Tom McMesser, John, takes a timeout. Obviously, he sees something that he wants to go with here in the next 4 minutes.
That makes it a six-point game, and that gives Cole just 6 points, well below her season average. Now Lincoln East is going to bring the defense out as Southeast spreads the floor here.
You're not going to see the Knights rush anything in this last 4 minutes. They're going to be patient. They're going to work the ball to Kim Schubert.
And there is Schubert. Outside, Suffolkul for three. Short. Rebound to Jenna Cole. See if the Spartans can make a push here. Southeast has been good on the defense. Tries to go between defenders and draws a foul. That's number 7 against Southeast. East has 10, so both teams are shooting free throws the rest of the way. And Jenna Cole goes to the free throw line.
Oh, that could be a key, too. Free throw shooting down the stretch if both teams are in the bonus. Still a lot of basketball to be played. 3:45, a lot can happen in that span of time.
Fosdick comes off the floor for Lincoln East as Jenna Cole toes the free throw line. 6 points for the Lincoln East junior. And she airballs the first. That won't happen often. Not to her.
Well, she had an emotional game yesterday against Millard West. And maybe a little of that has worn on her this afternoon.
And Southeast calls a timeout. Good heads-up play by the senior Tatum Tease. Knew that 5-second count was on and
30-second timeout.
Calls the timeout. So Southeast burns a 30 here. Timeout situation. Both teams each have 3 left. Possession arrow does belong to Lincoln Southeast. And as we mentioned, the foul situation. East has already gone to the double bonus, or put Southeast in the double bonus. The Knights have committed 7 fouls. Players in foul trouble, Schubert and Megan Hill, who's on the bench, with 3 fouls for Southeast, 3 fouls for Reynoldson, 3 fouls on Fosdick, 3 fouls on Cole. So that's how your game looks right now. With 3 minutes and 42 seconds left to play. You wonder if Lincoln East has another push in them. They've been as close as 3, but they can't get past really the imaginary barrier of 5 points. Barely got it in to beat the count. Pressure in the backcourt. Tease is in trouble. 10-second count is on. They outlet down the floor, and now they've got the numbers. Reynoldson stops in the lane. Ill-advised shot. Suffolkul, though, keeps it alive for Lincoln Southeast. Oh, that was close. Skip pass across the floor. McKinnon's going to take it in. Goes in hard and a charge. Reynoldson drawing the charge. On Cassie McKinnon.
That was a nice move by Cassie McKinnon, too. She faked the defender out of her shoes, had a clear path to the basket. But there was a defender right there before she got to the hoop. She couldn't avoid her.
Fosdick back in the game. She takes it across the timeline. A 6-point lead for Lincoln Southeast.
Let's see who can step up and hit a shot here for Lincoln East.
Tried the bounce pass it in, and last touch by Southeast. Another dangerous pass. Schwartz trying to go between the legs there to get it to Jenna Cole. They're really trying to get her in the offense in the post, but Southeast doing a great job of denying every entry pass. Open three. Oh. Yes!
Oh, that was
Rachel Schwartz has made it a 3-point game.
And this crowd has come alive. They are on their feet in blue.
As close as it's been since early stages third quarter. Pressure. Now Southeast with numbers. Schubert passes. Ill-advised pass. She could have taken it in, put up the shot. She probably could have drawn the foul. Instead, tried to pass off. to Los, who was not in position to make the catch, and now the Spartans can tie it with a three.
And John, this is a huge possession right here. You've got them on the ropes. This is where you make your push.
And you don't need to take the three.
No.
Sometimes just the thought that you can tie the game makes you want to do things you don't have to do. And Schubert has committed her fourth foul as Cole takes it in on the Southeast senior. And now the drama builds with 2:20 left.
Jenna Cole posting up, tries to go maybe for that little banker off the glass. Kim Schubert had no choice but to foul. I think a good foul, even though she has three, you can't give up an easy hoop like that with 2 minutes to go.
Cole, who airballed her last free throw attempt.
John, I'm a little surprised that in these final minutes, John Larson has kept Megan Hill on the bench. She's been very effective in there. And for her to still be on the bench right now is a little surprising.
That's a very good point, and Lincoln Southeast has taken a timeout. They have two left. It is now a two-point game. It has not been this close since we started. East has never led. We have one more free throw coming up for Jenna Cole. And you're reminded of the last 2 years. Southeast with the lead in the fourth quarter against Marion. It faded away. Marion wins in overtime. Last year, they had the lead against Bellevue East. Last second shot wins it for the Chieftains. Is history about to repeat itself again? Is the great tradition and the dominance of Lincoln Southeast about to be star-crossed? You almost get that sense here. Who on that floor for Lincoln Southeast needs to make a play to prevent that from happening?
I think you gotta look to Carrie Suppacool. She's a second half player. She's been rather quiet here today. Only 3 points on the day. And then you go to your big person, Kim Schubert. But like I said, I'm just surprised Megan Hill is on the bench. Southeast did their best work when she was in the game along with Schubert.
Here's Cole to make it a 1 point game. Now Fosdick will come out, Annie Rice comes in. This is a defensive substitution, and they're gonna sick the dogs on Lincoln Southeast. The pressure is on.
Look out for the 10-second call, it could come. She better get it up court.
And Tease breaks it. Here we go, coming up on 2 minutes to play. Tease, bounce pass
nice.
Down low, Schubert was wide open.
That's beautiful. That's senior leadership right there, senior to senior. Getting a good shot, waiting, working the defense down. Beautiful, can't be done better than that.
44 to 41, a 3-point game once again. Hinkley, they look down low, here she comes underneath. And that time Schubert had to back off, but was in position just enough to make Cole alter her shot.
Now the question is, when do you foul? Do you foul now, do you wait? Southeast is not gonna take another shot, I don't think.
I would be surprised. Near foul there on Schubert. They don't call it, minute 13, minute 12. Southeast leads by three. That pressure coming.
Oh, Reynoldson's down, Schubert's free.
Schubert's free, but doesn't go in.
And
trying
Andy
to
Reynolds.
Poke the ball out from behind. 5 second count was on for a moment. Boy, that was close. And now we have a foul, and it's gonna go against Melissa Hinkley, and that's just her second. And now we're gonna have free throws.
And Amy Reynoldson is hurt. She's shaken up, has her hands on her shorts, limping. She had a collision right there with Schubert, and she got the worst of it. She's gonna come out of the game right now, and the hero from 2 days ago is gonna come in, Sedlak.
Keep in mind, Jenna Fosdick is still on the bench right now for Lincoln East. I'm a little surprised. You got less than a minute to go. The two-shot situation. Remember, East, actually now both teams in the double bonus. And now here comes Fosdick. She misses the first, but this free throw still important for Cassie McKinnon. It would make it a two-possession game. All right, What does East do here? 55 seconds left. They need two possessions to tie or win. And Todd Mittmesser wants to take a timeout. He's got two left. 50.5 seconds left to go.
I think you go for two here.
Yeah.
I'd go for two, get a quick hoop, and then force Southeast to make another free throw.
Well, you've got a couple of timeouts left, so if you can get the two, you call the timeout, you set up your press, you try to make something happen with a steal and see what happens. If not, you foul. And I tell you, even though Kim Schubert is your top player for Lincoln Southeast, she is just 5 of 12 from the free throw line. I wouldn't be afraid to go after her.
Here you see the great play. This may be the play of the game. Tatum Dees, with all the momentum on Lincoln Southeast side, drives the lane. Schubert's wide open. She gets it to her for the easy hoop. That's senior leadership, John, and making the plays when you need to have them.
50.5 seconds left. Southeast 45, East 41. Each team two timeouts left. Possession arrow to Lincoln Southeast. Both teams in the double bonus. Schubert on the floor for the Knights with four fouls. But the Knights have the most important stat of all, the lead. And it's a two-possession lead. They'll get it into Cole. This possession, vital to Lincoln East hopes. They look underneath. They'll go up against Schubert. And they're going to call the foul. And that's it. Kim Schubert is out of here. Here it is. You make the call.
I think it was a correct call. She put her right arm down and got the arm of Rachel Schwartz. She's going to come out now, and here comes Megan Hill. I don't think this is that tough of a loss right now. There's only 42 seconds left in the game, and Megan Hill is more than a reasonable replacement.
It's a tough loss if we go into overtime.
Exactly. Good point.
Or if Lincoln East somehow comes out of here with the win in regulation. They're down by four. Need these free throws from Rachel Schwartz.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Wow.
I mean, every inch. I mean, that probably came off the right fingernail to go in. I mean, that's how close this state championship is going to be decided.
Missed the second. It was almost down. Three-point game. 38 seconds left. Pressure in the backcourt and a foul. It's going to go against Schwartz. And really, now we have set ourselves up in a position where if Southeast makes their free throws, they win the game. As simple as that. And you might recall that Southeast was in a position like this a year ago, and they didn't make their free throws.
It's so tough to step up to that line. It's one thing, John, as a former player, it's one thing, it's easy to be critical on, but there is nothing compared to in sports than stepping up to the free throw line with the game on the line and hands in the background. And it's just not easy.
She makes the second, again, two possession lead. Almost 30 seconds left. Spartans need a bucket here. Fosdick looking for Cole. Has no teammate there. 25. Now they go to Cole. Kick it out. They're trying to find an open shot. Sedlak for three. No. Rebound fought for. Southeast had it, and a foul. And that, I'm not going to say may do it, but it sure drew John Larson closer to his eighth championship.
Lincoln East got the shot they wanted. Sedlak had it opening there in the corner, but just a hair short. And Megan Hill has played outstanding all game, gets the big rebound, and now she's going to go to the line with a chance to ice it.
46-42 now. Even if she makes them both, it's still a two-possession game, but those two possessions have to be threes, and you have less than 15 seconds to do it. So advantage right now is tremendously in the favor of Lincoln Southeast. It would take not a miracle, but pretty doggone close to it to bring the Spartans back from this. 8 championships for Lincoln Southeast. And another amazing statistic, they have played 12 semifinal games at the state tournament and they have never lost.
Well, this would be a big step if the girls are able to hang on here. Of course, the boys will make their run next week. And that's a whole nother story, but you talk about a team that's overdue for a state championship. It'd be the Southeast boys, but I think them in the stands watching their girl classmates get this done today would give them a lot of confidence going into next week.
Well, we still have some game to play. Megan Hill, she's played a pretty doggone good game today. These will be just her second and third free throw attempts of the contest.
And you know, this is a player who probably understands that basketball's not her number one game. I mean, she's a volleyball player. But you see her in a championship atmosphere come up big like this, score in double figures and be a presence like she was, it's saying something.
6-point lead. East has to get a three off quickly. Fosdick trying to work off the screen, gets it up and Gordon in a timeout with 6 seconds left. Jenna Fosdick not giving up the ship yet. She was so cool when she came down the floor. I mean, it's like there was no rush in her at all.
She's got a good stroke.
But, all right, they got half the equation. Here's the problem. You got to get the ball back. And you only have 5.8 seconds left. And Lincoln East is out of timeouts now.
Here's the problem, too. Who do you foul? I mean, Megan Hill off the bench has shown she can hit free throws.
Yeah.
Kip Schubert's not in the game, but Tatum Thies, this senior, you know, I'd probably hesitate to put her on the line. Suffolkul, McKinnon, all these girls, they've been to the wars. It's tough to figure out who to foul. I think you just foul whoever gets the ball.
Well, you make an all-out push for the steal, but you still have to keep somebody back. Because if they don't get the steal and Southeast is able to outlet down the floor, you've got to have someone back there as a safety to get the foul before too much time runs off the clock. So a lot of strategy being played out here right now. Still advantage Southeast because they have the ball and a three-point lead.
Right now,
and there's no timeouts for East. Very important. Right. So even if they do get the steal, it's not like they can call a timeout and set up a last-second play.
Right now what you do not guard the inbounder, as they're not going to do. Put an extra person back, like you said, that's going to be Jenna Cole, and just put players in front of their players and hope that you can generate a steal.
They get it into Hill to Tease. Time ticking away and a foul. With 3.1 seconds left, it's come down to this. If Tease can make one free throw, the game is over. If she does not, then Lincoln East has to make a furious push down the floor and put up a prayer for three. Tatum Thies, 5'5 senior, 4.7 points, 3 rebounds per game. The biggest free throw of her young career. And now John Larson's going to call timeout just to ensure. And you see him pump his fist into the air. He knows that that free throw just iced his 8th state championship.
Tatum Thies, fittingly, even though she ices the game on that free throw, I think the play of the game was when Lincoln East was threatening and they had him on the ropes. And she came down, split the defense, and made the great pass to Kim Schubert to get that hoop. I think that was the play of the game.
No doubt about it, because without that basket changed the course of the game.
Exactly.
And gave Lincoln Southeast that second possession cushion that they needed to preserve this lead. And to keep anyone from Lincoln East making a bit at heroics.
Well, you see the girls' big smiles on their faces. Oh. These girls have earned it.
Well, you know, some people say, well, it's hard to feel good for a team that's won so many state titles, but for this senior class, they've never had one.
No.
And it's a rarity that a senior class goes through Lincoln Southeast without having tasted a state championship. This senior class is going to do what last year's senior class could not. And here's one of them right here. Tatum Thies. Boy, what a game effort by Lincoln East. They made it tight down at the stretch, but Lincoln Southeast made the plays when they had to get the win. Long inbounds play. And she stepped on the sideline. But it's immaterial now. Southeast will inbound. Tease will bring it in. And that, my friends, will cap off a great 8 state championship for Lincoln Southeast.
The familiar fight song played proudly this afternoon. Lincoln Southeast, just a pleasure, just a great team to cover all year long, as well as Lincoln East, two great teams today. Southeast, though, is a team just a little bit better.
50-45, Lincoln Southeast, state champions in Class A, and we're back after this.
The Nebraska Legislature is back in session, and you can see live coverage on NETV2. From gavel to gavel, follow all the events as they happen from the floor of the unicameral. Plus, watch statewide each week for more in-depth reporting on Nebraska's lawmakers. Watch and be more informed.
From the University of Nebraska Lincoln, this is NETV.
The win not only gives Lincoln Southeast their 8th state title, but it also continues a streak. It's been a decade of dominance. At least one Lincoln school, boys or girls, has come away with a state basketball championship. Now let's get the sportsmanship award and the medal presentations to our two finalists.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Nebraska Coaches Association and the Nebraska Athletic Administrators Association are proud to support the positive aspects of high school athletics. Good sportsmanship is a key factor in our philosophy, and at this time, we are pleased to present the Class A Sportsmanship Award. These beautiful awards are graciously donated by Awards Unlimited. Making the presentation and representing the Nebraska Coaches Association is Bill Carlin of Adams Central High School. And representing the Nebraska Athletic Administrators Association is Mike Purdy of Bellevue East High School. Ladies and gentlemen, the Class A Sportsmanship Award winner is Lincoln Southeast High School. Representing Lincoln Southeast High School is the Southeast Cheerleaders. Congratulations. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the Nebraska School Activities Association is pleased to present medals and trophies to both of these outstanding teams. The awards will be presented by NSAA Board of Control members Dr. Marshall Adams of Seward and Nate Steinman of Southern Valley. They will be assisted by U.S. Bank Representative Dolores Terway. First, here are the awards for the 2003 Class A runner-up. From Lincoln East High School will head coach Todd Mittmesser and your assistants step toward to the middle of the court to present the silver medals to each member of your team. Players, as your name is called, please come forward to receive your medal. Number 10, Annie Rice. Number 12, Jenna Cole. Number 14, Sarah Sedlak. Number 20, Rachel Schwartz. Number 22, Jenna Fosdick. Number 24, Amy Reynoldson. Number 30, Jenna Schultz. Number 32, Melissa Hinckley. Number 34, Carly Poole. Number 40, Allison Ehlers. Number 44, Amanda Leitner. And number 52, Jennifer Beth. All of you are welcome to receive the runner-up trophy for your school. Congratulations, Lincoln East High School, Class A, state runner-up. Allison Poole. And number 52, Jenna Hetzko. And now, all of you are welcome to receive the state championship trophy. Congratulations to the Knights of Lincoln Southeast High School, the Class A state basketball champions.
Eight times the women of the black and gold have lifted that trophy, and for this senior class, a very special moment. It made up for two straight years of frustration. Lincoln Southeast wins it over Lincoln East in the Class A state championship game. And now let's head courtside with Kyle D'Elia. He's with Lincoln East coach Todd Mittmesser.
Thanks, John. Coach, I know it's easy for us to say and cliche-ish, but I mean, it was an unbelievable ball game. A great play from your kids. No excuses coming off two long games. You got to be proud of your kids.
Oh, definitely. A lot of teams wish they were second, I think, but kids are disappointed. Obviously, we just didn't play well to start the game off. That really hurt us getting that hole, but they gave it their all, though, that's for sure. Played hard.
Part of intensity is you know, to be happy, but to look forward, and that's what you have. I saw you crack a smile. That's nice to see. I know you're proud of him. Going down the roster, I wish I could name every kid. You lose the three seniors, but sophomore, junior. So, I mean, that's the purity of high school sports, what you've built, what the program has built. They play with club teams. You guys are loaded for the future. That's what you're trying to create here.
You said it.
Man, a few words. Hey, thanks for stopping by. Great showing by your Spartans.
Thank you, Kyle. Appreciate it.
You got it. Really, nothing to hang their head about. We were just talking to Coach Cook, who comes on the next game. He said there's only runners-up. It's a great production how they give the trophy. John, Drew, you guys have hit on so many points, which I could chime in. But, hey, how about the fans? You know, the rivalry, sometimes it gets a little out of hand. Great fans on both ends cheering at the end, and that's what it's all about. John, back to you.
Well, no doubt about it. Lincoln should be proud. As we mentioned, it's been a decade now where at least one Lincoln team has won a state basketball championship, whether it be boys or girls. And Lincoln Southeast, the girls program, has been a big, big, big part of that. And Lincoln basketball fans, they know what kind of special thing they have. So many good players have come through these programs, and really the feeder programs to the high schools have to be given a lot of credit. When we come back, stats, interviews, and we'll wrap up session number one in a moment.
The legends of rhythm, blues, and soul unite for an event 40 years in the making to benefit public television.
To thank PBS for having this wonderful occasion.
Sunday night at 8 Central Time on NETV.
Programming on NETV is provided in part by Bryan LGH Medical Center in Lincoln, nationally recognized by AARP for its work in orthopedics. Bryan LGH also received nationwide acclaim for its success in cardiovascular services. And the medical center has been recognized nationally for its support of working mothers. Bryan LGH, the first name in healthcare.
Story time. We'll read the story about the big dog. Yes, on the way to school.
Always there when you need us. Nebraska Public Power District, together with your local public power utility.
NETV is a service of the Nebraska Educational Telecommunications Commission.
Lincoln Southeast, a 50-45 win over Lincoln East in the state championship game. Let's take a look at the final numbers before we go backstage for interviews. Kim Schubert leading the way with 17 points, 12 points for Tatum Thies, and Megan Hill with 10 to lead the champion Knights. For the Spartans, Jenna Fosdick with 13 and Melissa Hinckley with 12. Great ball game. Hope you enjoyed it. Now it's time for the post-game interviews. Southeast, the state champions. No runner-up interviews this year. We'll go back now to Andrew, who is with head coach John Larson.
Yeah, John. John Larson has done the runner-up interviews the past 2 years, so it's good to have you back here in the winner's locker room. And a very emotional year, 400 wins, but most importantly, a state championship.
Well, the state championship is much better than the 400, believe me. And, you know, this feels real good after the last 2 years. We were close and left here kind of pretty disappointed, so this makes feel a lot better.
As a team, though, I mean, there are really no superstars on this team, but as a team, just how key was it that your girls were able to play within themselves and play with each other like they did?
Well, I think the fact that they get along with each other so well, they're not jealous of each other. They cheer for each other. They're happy when one has success, and I think that's key, because then they help each other both offensively, defensively, and that's what makes a good team.
Coach, congratulations, and it's been a pleasure covering your team all year.
Thank you very much.
Okay, let's get a few of your team girls in here. Who's first? Let's go with Kim Schubert first. Kim Schubert joining us. Number 40, the senior for Lincoln Southeast, a scholar athlete. If you would just step maybe a step closer. Congratulations. Just talk about, I thought this was the best game you've played all season. Although I know point totals have been bigger and clutch situations, excuse me, it's been a long game. Talk about just what you were able to do out there.
Well, it was just really a really good team effort, and we had a lot of great passes and good defense. So, I mean, I'm just really happy to be part of this team.
What is it about Lincoln East? You guys really shocked them at the start, got out to the fast start. What is it about them? You guys just play better when you play them.
I don't know, just city rivalry maybe, and I don't know, we were really fired up, and so just really excited.
Kim, congratulations, enjoy this one. Let's bring in one of your teammates, Jamie Loos. Jamie Loos, come on in here. Congratulations, of course, very familiar with your family, but just talk about the joy of winning a state championship.
It just means so much to me to be on this team for the first time and we win state. There's so many great people on this team, and I'm just happy that I got to play with them and win state with them.
It's been a while since Lincoln Southeast has had a basketball championship, too. What does this mean to the school now?
Oh, it means a lot. We're just so excited about it. I can't even explain how excited we are.
Well, congratulations and have fun tonight. Okay. Megan Hill, not a starter, but I thought your play off the bench was such a key. Just talk about how you were able to come in the game and, you know, have some great moves down there and really score and get to the free throw line.
I mean, it's not really starting on our team. Our whole bench just comes in there every time, just, you know, works hard. You know, our starters are awesome players, but the great thing about our team is that our bench, I mean, can come in and just take their places and just really, you know, give it their all. And I mean, tonight it happened to be that, you know, our bench had a great game and it worked out.
And no offense, but the sport you probably play better, volleyball, you guys were shocked and upset, did not get to the state championship. So how rewarding was it to come in and play as well as you did and for you guys to win this game?
Definitely. I mean, the state championship is always something, you know, an athlete works through, you know, in high school.